joy, the life of every creature, the breath of all mankind, a new beginning. Your promises are written in creation. Oh, everywhere I look, I see your plan.
Oh, Hey, good morning, everyone. So glad that you guys are here. We are going to pause in our time of worship and receive the Lord's Supper. We're going to celebrate that together. So you should have received your elements as you came in, but just in case you didn't, our guest services team, they're here. If you'll just raise your hand to be sure you get those elements, and then I'll just give you a moment, because I know we all need a moment to, you know, get our cellophane ready there, because that can throw all of us off for a moment. So as we prepare our hearts for this time, let's have a moment to just pray and to reflect. So let's pray. Heavenly Father, we approach you humbly this morning, but we also approach your throne with boldness and with confidence, knowing that Jesus made the way, that our mediator provided the opportunity where we could go to you. We can enter into the Holy of Holies. We can enter into your presence. But Lord, what we do is we celebrate and remember what you've done. We're mindful of our sinfulness. We're mindful of our brokenness. And so, Lord, we come before you with genuine, repentant hearts. So examine our hearts this morning. Just root out anything that offends you. Thank you for this time of communion with our Heavenly Father. On the night before Jesus was crucified with his disciples there, he took bread and he broke it and he said, "This is my body." And Jesus is the bread of life. So let's receive the wafer. And then he took the chalice of wine. He said, "This is the blood of the new covenant. And when you drink of this, do this in remembrance of me." It's a reminder that his shed blood makes us whole, makes us righteous, makes us pure. You may receive that. Heavenly Father, thank you. Thank you for the work of your son, Jesus. Thank you that because of his work, our sin is atoned for. We can enter into your Holy of Holies. We can enter into your presence, God. Not because of anything we've done. Not because of any striving or any effort, but trusting in the work of Jesus on the cross. Trusting that our old life is gone, has been crucified, buried, and gone. And trusting that we pick up new life, resurrected life. Thank you, Lord, that we're united in heart, mind, and purpose as we do this in remembrance of you with brothers and sisters in Christ throughout the centuries. We thank you that we can join together in doing this, Lord. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Thank you.
Christ be magnified.